Hello. This video is to demonstrate the Division of Drinking Groundwater's PWS LTO Pre-Application. This application was developed as an online application for public water system owner or administrative contacts to update water system information. The application allows the user to update phone numbers, email addresses, and mailing addresses for owners, administrative, and financial contacts for the public water system. In addition, the user can also update the water system populations, service connections, and seasonal operating period if they are a system that's closed partially during the year. It also allows the user to generate a PWS operator of record notification form that you can print off for signatures in hard copy submittal to DDAGW's operations section. The application is accessed through the agency's customer support center. A link to this site can be found under the LTO tab on the PWS webpage or under the Do Business dropdown at the top of every Ohio EPA webpage. Applicants have been sent a login ID associated with their water system or systems. The first step will be to reset the password for your account. Once you have set your password and logged into the application, a list of water systems or system will be displayed. Each PWS has a link to revise the water system information. If you did not receive a login or you need to change the person that was assigned the login, please contact Brian Tarver at the Division of Drinking and Groundwaters. In order to complete the PWS inventory application form, the following information will be required to have on hand when you go to fill this out. You'll need the population served, number of service connections, annual operating period if the system is not open year-round, contact information for the owner, financial contact, and administrative contact that'll include name, address, phone numbers, and email, the list of certified operators for each classified facility, that would be each treatment plant and the distribution. You'll need their name, their certification number, and their expiration date. The first time you come into the application from the customer support center, you'll select the login link at the top right-hand side of the page. And then select the forgot your username or password link. Then go to the reset your password section and type in your username that we sent you. Most likely it will be your email address and click reset my password. An email will be sent to your account with a link to set your new password. In the email, click the reset password link. Now enter your password and verify the password and click submit. This will open the contact information page for your account. Complete any information that may be missing. You should not need to check the consultant checkbox. Once completed and updated, click Save Changes. Once you have saved changes, select the account link at the top right-hand side of the page. This will display your LTO application for the water system. You will select the revise link under the action column to launch the PWS information. Your contact information will be displayed. verify and or correct any incorrect information, and click the next button. PWS service connection information will be displayed. PWS information displayed is as a reference information and cannot be edited. The connection section will allow you to update the number of service connections for your PWS, and click next. This page displays your seasonal annual operating period and associated populations. Generally, the season information will not need to be updated as most PWSs are open year-round. However, some systems like campgrounds may need to change their open and close dates. Under the population section, you can update the current population numbers and click next. This page will display the PWS contact information. There will be an owner, an administrative, and a financial contact. You may update the addresses, phone numbers, and emails for each existing contact. If the contact needs to be completely changed, select Replace This Contact checkbox. If this is checked, the next page will require you to enter the information for the new contact. Note, some fields are required for under the contact information. When a phone number and email address are required to be where a phone number and email address are required to be entered. Note on the system, we have updated contact information for the owner and financial contact and have chosen to replace the administrative contact. Select next and enter the contact information for the new administrative contact. And note again that some of the contact information is required. Excuse me. For the administrative contact, we require a business and emergency phone as well as an email address. Once again, it will give you an error notice if you are trying to move forward without supplying the required information. Once complete, click next. This next page displays the current operators of record for each of the PWS facilities, each plant and the distribution. You can select to add additional operators and you're able to remove any operators from each facility. Note that if you remove all of the operators from the system, it will require you to add at least one back on the following page. So enter the new operator's name and select next. And only select the add another operator for the facility if you're adding more than one new operator. If you're just adding one, click next. Now enter the operator certificate number. Make sure you're using the format displayed below the field. And then enter the expiration date for his certificate. This is the certification page. Read and acknowledge the certification statements at the top. Verify that you are authorized to submit and consent to using the electronic signature block. The signature block, sign as best you can using your mouse or touchscreen. Below that, type print your name and your title. Click next. Now you want to open and review the draft copy of any changes you made. This will open a PDF of a summary of what you have just done. Review all of the changes. If anything does not look correct, close the PDF and select the back button to return to the pages you may need to correct. List your contacts, any new contacts you added. A summary of the operators of record at your facilities, any that are removed. And any that were added. Signature page and the operator of record notification form. This you would have to print and get all the signatures on it and physically mail into our office. If all looked correct, you'll need to check that you have reviewed that form and click next and submit your changes. This, once you hit submit, it will lock your application. You won't be able to return to it to make any additional changes until we have processed the information you've sent us. When you submit, you'll have two forms down at the bottom, a confirmation of receipt of this application and a copy of the final application for your records. Final application that you submitted to us. You'll want to save a copy of this for your records. And that is the PWS LTO pre-application form, and it's completed at this point.